As the coronavirus restrictions in Peru began to ease, traveling to Peru is no longer a distant horizon dream. The borders in Peru are now open to travelers, with a mandatory quarantine being lifted in favor of a negative antigen test that can be taken either at the airport or on arrival to your destination, organized by either your hotel or your travel company. While it is possible to do a do-it-yourself tour, it's not necessarily recommended, as you will come into contact with many people, and thanks to the current rule that molecular tests must be taken for bus rides that last longer than 5 hours, this rule essentially renders the previous popular backpacker route no longer viable, as it would require from 3 to 5 molecular tests throughout your journey and expose you to unnecessary risk. A tour company will have existing COVID-19 protocols in place, which will ensure your safety. First of all, you have to wear a mask in public. Masks are a regular feature of Peruvian life in the post-pandemic world. They are worn at all times, both outside and in the public spaces, such as transport, shops, outdoor markets, etc. You will be expected to wear a mask at all times, and when on public transport, such as the train to Machu Picchu or on flights, you will also be expected to wear a face shield. Both masks and face shields are readily available throughout Peru, in shops and from street sellers. You will have no problem getting your hands on one. Regular temperature checks and hand wash. When entering any public building, including health centers, supermarkets, restaurants, and at your hotel, obviously, you will be expected to have your temperature taken and either wash your hands or accept a squirt of hand sanitizer or alcohol. There will be a sort of doormat full of disinfection fluid for you to stand in order to disinfect the bottom of your shoes. Your temperature will be taken with an infrared thermometer and is usually taken from your wrist, your forehead, or your neck. The process takes around 2 seconds and you will not be touched. Maintain social distancing. Social distancing is required while traveling around Peru in the pandemic. This is to protect yourself and the others around you. When queuing up in a place, such as in your hotel lobby, in the airport, at a supermarket, there will be markers on the floor to indicate where is safe to stand. Carry your affidavit or your health affidavit. When you are entering Peru, you will be asked to complete a health affidavit. Print a copy of this off and keep it with you at all times, along with a photocopy of your passport and identification information. You should also keep evidence of your most recent negative test with you at all times. You may need a molecular test to fly. A molecular test is no longer a travel restriction for domestic flights in Peru. However, they are a requirement for almost all international airlines for travel. This means as you enter and exit Peru, you will need to take a molecular test. This can be organized through your hotel or through your travel company, if you are coming through a travel company, for sure. Get insured before your trip to Peru. This is very important. While I always recommend travelers to have a travel insurance policy, now more than ever, it is very important to do so. This is because a good insurance claim will protect you if anything goes wrong, and some will even cover a hotel and a new flight if you contract the virus and need to self-quarantine in Peru for 14 days. While this is not likely, it is always best to be prepared. Are Peruvian tourist sites like Machu Picchu open? In short, yes. They are all working at a 30% to 50% capacity, but the number of visitors seen rarely reaches the already lowered capacity. This is because previously Peru was suffering from over-tourism, whereas now there is hardly a tourist to be seen. There are some things that are closed, such as the Inca Trail. However, alternatives are available, such as the Lares Trek. So why travel to Peru in pandemic? It is a wholly unique opportunity to see some of the most incredible ruins in South America, with hardly anyone there. Machu Picchu, which pre-COVID would see 5,000 visitors a day, now hardly sees 50 visitors. Is traveling to Peru in pandemic, please remember, these precautions are not optional. If you are found without a mask in the street, then you could be fined. If you refuse temperature checks or hand sanitizer, you will be denied entry to where you intend to go. It is very important to remember that these precautions are not there to impede or disrupt your time in Peru. Rather, they are there to protect you and to protect the people around you. You know, this is a time of uncertainty, and our country has an uncertain healthcare service. These were the current traveler restrictions to Peru. If you like this video, please thumbs up, because many people want to know which are the current restrictions to travel to Peru. Please give me your comments, activate the bell, and see you in the next video. Ciao!